Hello everyone and welcome back to another album review, and in this video I'm going to review Loom by Katie Gately. My introduction with Katie Gately's music started with her debut album Colors that she released back in 2016. This was a decent album for standards of like art pop and electronic music. As far as I vaguely remember Colors as an album, I can definitely say that her sophomore one, Loom, has nothing to do with it. It is definitely a change of direction, which after a while, after one or two songs, I was curious as of what's with this change of direction, because we definitely got a far darker and more melancholic sound. And then everything makes sense when you learn that this album is about her mother's passing back in 2018. As it's described, her mother died from a rare form of cancer, and so this second album is dedicated to her. And you can definitely hear some of the harrowing and devastating emotions going into this whole experience. And as she states, she was going for another album, but after the news of her mother just being diagnosed with this rare form of cancer, she just couldn't process herself making that album anymore. So she ended up with Loom, with her vocals being more upfront in the mix on this one, being heavily passionate, and this album in general is quite heavy. You can also tell from this album cover, which has a really devastating feel to it in a sense. This whole empty and destructive space feels like everything is just about to collapse. But there is just a slight glimpse of hope with this light just coming through some of those empty walls. And this whole album has such a euphoric feel coming from a quite dark place. Meanwhile, when it comes to the instrumentation to this thing, this is a quite devastating album and also going more to the horrifying scheme of things. As in this album, she gets a bit more sort of aggressive with some of their sounds, as they tend to go a bit more out there with some industrial soundscapes, some anxiety-inducing minimalism and repetitiveness with some of the percussion segments. Take tracks like Tower, for example. The introduction with this sort of militaristic industrialized drums feels like the beginning of a track out of Pharmakon's earlier works. The vocals, though, get you into a different mood since they're more ethereal. You're not getting like horrifying screams of shredding power electronics like with Pharmakon or Pius Mary. This is not the case. And another very interesting aspect of this album is that it has this art pop feel to it, but the instrumentation also has a glimpse of modern classical music. This goes with some of the main structures of just minimal classical music in some of the occasions of the songs. The vocals have a sort of opera feel to them. They're just filled and stacked with so many beautiful layers that enhance the instrumentation, and also has a sort of an epic feel to it, as there are build-ups to some of the songs and they get more grand and more bright when they go on, just having more and more layers of instrumentation. But the whole feel to it, with its minimalism but also with some of its complexity with its structures, gives a neoclassical feel. Meanwhile, in this 8-track album, there are contained 3 interludes in the intro with the track Ritual, halfway towards the album with the track Ride, and in the outro with the track Rest. And those 3 tracks feel more like interlude moments, with the main sort of instrument in all of those occasions being Katie's voice. These 3 tracks have slight portions of instrumentals to them, and they emphasize more into the vocals, And this whole sort of repetitive process with some of the vocal palettes reminds me some of the works out of Medulla from Björk, which was the main album where we see Björk getting more into this a cappella sort of style and raising her voice and other people's voice as the main instrument. Those three sort of interlude tracks might not be to my favorite moments in this album, but they certainly enhance this whole experience with their ethereal feel. When it gets to some of the longer tracks of the album, this whole feel gives me like I'm listening to an ethereal version of like Lingua Ignotas, Caligula. The main things that miss are the haunting screams, the very distorted sounds, and the metal segments, as Loom is a fairly more balanced album, going to a mostly specific crowd, not trying to be that unpredictable. On the other hand, I would also recommend this album for fans of like Björk or Zola Jesus. Her instrumentation might not go to some of the more electronic and out there parts, but the minimal instrumentation and the whole modern classical feel she presents to this album definitely makes it a very powerful and very bright and really dynamic album with very nice production to it, some great industrial soundscapes, like I said, and also the vocals, the way the layers of vocals are stacked through this whole thing, they're gorgeous. And they work perfectly for tracks like Allay and Waltz. Meanwhile, the track Bracer is the first teaser track, which is a track that goes for 10 and a half minutes long. And as far as this track has some of the greatest moments, I think that it takes a bit of it to just pick up. When it picks up towards the end of it, it just gets really epic and really emotional and powerful, but it is a bit long in my opinion. With just being 10 minutes, there is a lot of space that could have been cut off in my opinion, but it's still a very good moment. And last but not least, the track Flow is a more minimal and more ethereal track to the mix. It doesn't go into some of those industrialized drum sections. It just mostly focuses on a minimal, repetitive sort of organ synth sound and layers of vocals upon this whole track. And it's a great atmospheric piece. There is no reason to compare Loom with her debut, because we're talking about a much different work coming from a darker place after a serious incident that led Kately making this powerful and heavily devastating album. But its whole ethereal feel has a very nice beauty to it, giving you a glimpse of hope, sort of like telling you to just never give up. This whole beauty is expressed very well with the vocals and the whole instrumentation on this thing. This is an album that I wouldn't expect I would like as much as I would, but for fans of like art pop with some modern neoclassical elements, I think you can find lots of things that you can dig out of this album. I'm going to give Loom an 8- out of 10. What's your opinion on this album? Like it, dislike it, why, and what do you want me to review next time? Let me know down in the comments. Leave a like if you enjoyed the video, subscribe for more content like this. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you all in the next video. Goodbye.